Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Shikha Uday Prabhu Lavande. I am doing my third year junior residency in the Department of Radio Diagnosis, Goa Medical College. Today I am here to present a presentation before you titled A Case Report on Radiological Manifestations of Melioidosis. Introduction. Melioidosis is a bacterial infection caused by Burkholderia pseudomallei seen predominantly in Southeast Asia and Northern Australia. It commonly infects the adults with an underlying predisposing health condition, mainly diabetes mellitus, chronic renal failure, alcoholism, malignancy, etc. Melioidosis has a wide spectrum of radiological manifestations. Almost every organ can get affected, but the most commonly affected organ is the lung, followed by the spleen and the liver. Diagnosis requires a high index of clinical suspicion in patients with septicemia or pyrexia of unknown origin, living in or with a travel history to endemic areas. Case history. A 31-year-old male patient presented to the emergency department with a 5-day history of high-grade fever and severe abdominal pain. Patient had history of alcoholic liver disease and was a known type 1 diabetic on insulin for 6 years with poor control of diabetes. On examination, patient was febrile, hypotensive with tachycardia. Blood pressure normalized after fluid resuscitation. On per-abdominal examination, there was hepatosplenomegaly with severe left hypochondriac tenderness. His laboratory investigations were performed, which revealed hemoglobin level of 10 grams per deciliter, RBSL of 450 milligrams per cent. The total leukocyte count was elevated to about 25,000 per cubic millimeters, of which neutrophils comprised 86% and lymphocytes were 13%. ESR was 100, serum bilirubin, SGOT, SGPT, ALP were all raised. Albumin globulin ratio was reversed, blood urea serum creatinine were normal, patient was evaluated for dengue and malaria. The results were negative. No history of tuberculosis or Cox contact was noted. Sputum AFP was negative. With this clinical background, the patient was subjected to radiological investigations that included chest X-ray and ultrasound abdomen and pelvis. This is a frontal radiograph of the chest, which in PA view, which revealed a well-defined radio-opacity in the mediastinum on the right side with its broad base towards the hilum. No air fluid levels or calcification noted within. Lung fields were clear, no evidence of pleural effusion. Ultrasound of the abdomen revealed hepatosplenomegaly, multiple multiloculated hypoechoic lesions of varying sizes were scattered throughout the liver and splenic parenchyma. This image shows you the spleen, which is definite of splenomegaly, and shows hypoechoic lesions scattered in the upper pole as well as the lower pole, with here perisplenic extension to the gastrosplenic ligament. These lesions showed minimal color uptick on Doppler evaluation. Transabdominal ultrasound at segment 5 of the liver showed a hypoechoic lesion made up of multiple locules of varying sizes with minimal intralesional Doppler signals. The differential diagnosis of these hepatic and splenic lesions, including that of the thorax, the right mediastinal radiopacity, included tuberculosis and melioidosis. The patient was then subjected to CCT, thorax and abdomen to characterize the lesions further. CCT abdomen revealed splenic abscesses with perisplenic extensions, which are described as follows. There was splenomegaly with multiloculated peripherally enhancing collections with internal enhancing septae at upper pole extending medially into the gastrosplenic ligament, abutting the tail of the pancreas and the body of the stomach. Superiorly, this collection extended into the subdiaphragmatic lesion. The collection of the lower pole extended inferiorly to come in close proximity to the splenic flexure of the colon. There was minimal perisplenic fat stranding noted. The splenic artery and the vein showed normal contrast opacification, ruling out or negating thrombosis. CCT of the liver at the level of main portal vein showed some lesions which had iso to hypodense center with small symmetric peripheral locules arranged in radial fashion. This resembled the necklace pattern of this hepatic abscess. Another lesion showed asymmetric locules of varying sizes with no extracapsular extension. This was representing a honeycomb pattern of the liver abscess. In the thorax, we saw patchy nodular airspace opacities in the apico-posterior segment of the left upper lobe and in the superior segment of the left lower lobe in subpleural location. A cavitary consolidation was noted in suprahilar location on the left side. Rest of the bilateral lung parenchyma was normal. Enlarged, heterogeneously enhancing necrotic lymph nodes were noted in the mediastinum. Further coming to the diagnosis and management, patient underwent laparotomy followed by splenectomy in view of the ruptured splenic abscess. The splenic abscess culture and the blood culture together revealed Burkholderia pseudomallei. Patient was diagnosed as a case of melioidosis with the background of blood culture, splenic abscess culture and supportive radiological findings. He was treated in the ICU for about 2 days with supportive therapy, which included presence of inotropes for his persistent hypotension and antibiotic therapy. The patient succumbed in a span of few days owing to his septicemia. Coming to the discussion, melioidosis is an important public health bacterial infection that presents with a wide variety of clinical manifestations affecting lungs, spleen, liver, kidneys and prostate. The most frequent presentation being fever with single or multiple abscesses. Imaging findings are not always specific and mimic other bacterial infections. It has a high mortality rate owing to the early spread of infection to the blood. There are different presentations of melioidosis as we have seen. So pulmonary melioidosis affects or manifests as consolidation, diffuse nodular opacities, which can involve the entire lung or cavitary nodules confined to the upper lobes predominantly. Visceral melioidosis encompasses multiple hypoechoic multiloculated abscesses in the liver, spleen, kidneys, prostate on ultrasound, which show peripheral enhancement with internal enhancing septae if present on contrast enhanced CT scan of the abdomen. Concomitant liver and splenic abscesses or splenic abscess alone are also suggestive of melioidosis. CNS melioidosis range from normal CT or MRI findings to well-defined macro abscesses in frontal lobes and brainstem. Also included are microabscesses, osteomyelitis, encephalitis and myelitis. Musculoskeletal system shows varied presentation in the form of osteomyelitis, soft tissue abscesses and rarely septic arthritis. The differential diagnosis represents bacterial, tubercular or fungal infections. In the conclusion, melioidosis is considered as a mimicker of maladies. Clinically and radiologically, it may imitate tuberculosis, malignancy, or any other disease, hence described as a great mimicker. Definite diagnosis cannot be made on radiographic features alone, but awareness of these manifestations can lead to early diagnosis and appropriate treatment. Diagnosis is mainly by a positive smear or culture, serological analysis by rising of indirect hemagglutination titers or a combination of both. These are my references. Thank you.